Hi, I'm Stacy Sigurdson, naturalist at Tamarack Nature Center. Shannon and I are out here at the beautiful teal pond, and it is flooded, and we are listening to the frogs. Take a listen. So there are primarily two different frogs that you're hearing. It's awesome because one group of them just started getting really loud. The ones over here that sound like they're going rack, 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 they're really funny. They are called wood frogs. The ones behind me that sound a little bit higher pitched and more like ping pong balls that are bouncing or your finger up a really fine tooth comb, those are chorus frogs. I've got a couple pictures I pulled off so you can look at them. So the loud quacking ones over here are the wood frogs. They're really tiny. They have a characteristic black mask on their face. And then up here, the ones that sound like those ping pong balls or the thumb up a fine tooth comb are the western chorus frogs or the boreal chorus frogs. They've got three stripes that run all the way from their snout all the way down the length of their body, and one stripe goes through their eye. They are tiny. One year I found one in our yard and it was tiny. They run anywhere from 3/4 of an inch to 1.5 inches, so they're small. So why are all the frogs making all this noise? And why are they at the pond? Well, it is mating season for them. So as soon as the water temperature and the air temperature warms up, the frogs congregate in mass at the pond. So, and at different times. So right now, the chorus frogs and the wood frogs are here. Later on in a couple weeks, we're gonna be hearing the tree frogs, the peepers, and the toads. They get together, the males call. They want to be as loud and robust as they can to attract a female. They can lay eggs. I read this morning up to 4,000 in a cluster. And then those eggs will hopefully not get all eaten and turn into tadpoles and then hatch into frogs. So later on we'll hear, like I mentioned, tree frogs and peepers and toads. Here's what the peepers sound like. They're a high pitch. They're also a tiny frog. The tree frogs, they're the ones that you might see outside your window, stuck up trying to catch moths and insects at night. Real buzzy. You'll hear them later in the summer too in the trees. And then also around maybe Mother's Day or fishing opener, you'll hear the deafening sound of the toads. Sounds kind of like an eerie trill. Well, all of these are fun to listen to. And one thing you can do if you're at all interested is go check out FrogWatch USA. It's a website and it's a citizen science project. And what that means is you get to go out on a schedule and get a little bit of training and go listen for the frog calls. Take the air temperature, take the water temperature, and see which frogs and toads you hear. And then you turn that data in so that they can start tracking and continue tracking where our amphibians are mating. So it's a great time of year to get out, and a lot of people are doing an awesome job getting out of their houses and their apartments, spreading out, getting some fresh air. Find a wetland, stop, take a deep breath, listen to the red-winged blackbirds and the frogs going crazy, and get some exercise. Keep your eyes peeled, because in the next few days we'll have some storytelling from a coworker, Bethany Ricks, as well as a creature feature. So take care, be well, and get outside when you can.